Today's question is, what is two-factor authentication and why should I care about it? Does it really help protect me from hackers? The answer is yes. Two-factor authentication absolutely does give you much better protection against hackers. So let's talk about what it is and why you should turn it on. So if you are working for a company, they might provide it for you, but Google will provide you with two-factor authentication on your Gmail account if you want it. Here's why you might want to think about it. A normal password is something you know. But if somebody guesses that, they could log in from Russia or China or Bulgaria or wherever. They could get access to documents. They could get access to the stuff that you have stored in Gmail. And that's pretty scary. Two-factor authentication is something you know, like your password, and something you have. So in this case, you might, for example, configure your smartphone to be able to return a little PIN. And that might be a 6-digit number that you just type in. And then, okay, not only do you know the password, but you also have this time-limited PIN, and so Google knows to trust you. Now, there's a lot of people who are sort of like, well, this sounds like a lot of hassle, or they're sort of pointing out the various corner cases. So let me walk you through it. I have had at least 2 relatives have their Gmail account get hacked because they didn't pick a good password. And so people are logging in from other countries, and they're trying to do various things. If you will turn on two-factor authentication, then you don't need to worry about that because whoever the hacker is, he doesn't have your phone. So he's not able to guess what your sort of one-time PIN is. And so you're much more protected. Now let's walk through a lot of the sort of concerns that people have. Some people are like, well, I don't want to type in a PIN every time I log in. That's great because you can set a little checkbox that says, remember me for 30 days. And so only once a month do you have to generate the PIN and type it in. Some people will say, well, but what if I'm in a foreign country, or what if I don't have cell phone service? That's okay. This application runs on your smartphone, but it doesn't have to have cell phone service. It's based on time so that, you know, over a limited window, this PIN will work, and then another PIN will start working. And so you don't have to have cell phone service. It's okay if you're in another country. Some people are like, well, what if I lose my phone? That's okay, too. There's little one-time codes that you can print out on paper and put in your wallet. If people say, well, what if I forget about my phone number and I switch to a different phone or something like that? That's okay. You can designate like a backup phone number where people can either send a text or they can actually automatically call and read off the number for you. Some people are like, oh, well, what if this is proprietary and it's not based on standards? That's okay. It's like open source and it's based on open standards. So I pretty much guarantee almost any given reservation that you have about whether you would be able to use this as your solution, they've pretty much taken care of all those weird corner cases. So I have it on my phone. I would not trust my Gmail account without having two-factor authentication. It just makes your system that much more secure. It's very little extra work. There's all kinds of ways to make it even faster. And I would just really recommend that everybody get it. If everybody would turn on two-factor authentication, we'd have much less of a problem with accounts getting hijacked, people's sites getting hacked, because your Gmail can be the source of a lot of information. And so if your Gmail gets hacked, then people might get access to your domain name or your other services, your bank. So you really should have a lot of protection on your Gmail account. And the Gmail guys do a lot of different things to say, okay, you know, here's a login from a different country, or there are ways to see the most recent account activity. But the really big one is this two-factor authentication. So it's a little tiny bit more hassle, but if you're willing to turn it on, then you get a lot more protection. I just feel like I'd be sort of naked out on the internet if I didn't have this sort of protection, and I really think everybody should turn it on, including you. So please consider it. I think that we have a video down in the metadata where we can link to that gives you a lot more information about how it works. There's all kinds of ways where you can set up application-specific passwords. So if you really want to do IMAP or POP and have access to your email without having to re-authenticate every 30 days, there's ways to do it. But if you just spend, you know, a little bit of time learning about it and how it works, I guarantee you'll be much more protected. So the next time somebody gets hacked, it won't be you.